Hi, welcome to the channel, and in today's video I'm going to show you five different graphic design techniques I think you should know in Word. So the first thing is we're just going to go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and just insert a circle. I'm going to hold down my Shift key to ensure the circle is an exact circle rather than an oval. There we go. And also just quickly go and show you the same with text. So Insert, we're going to go to Word Art and we're going to click on this first letter here. Move that up. And then we're just going to type the word text. And I'm just going to increase the size of that by just going up to this icon here, increase font size. Graphics can refer to text or shapes. So I'm going to show you how this works with both of these elements. So whenever we're editing graphics in Word, it's best to access the full menu. So if you select your shape, go to Shape Format, and go along to this icon here, Format Pane, and click on that. You can do the same with the text. If you select the text and go to Shape Format, again, Format Pane will appear over here. So what we'll have over here is shape options and text options. So if we first select the shape, you can see we've got this bucket icon here. We've also got fill and line. All shapes will come with a border line as well as a fill color. So you can't really see the line at the moment, the border line. If we go down to width here, and let's just insert 20, press enter, now you can see that border line. So every single shape and text will come with a border line. This means that you can then go up to the fill color, which is currently blue, and go to no fill, and therefore you have a transparent fill color, and you can use just the outlines. If you want to fill this with text or an image, then you can just use the border line for your graphics, and then you can obviously copy and paste that or hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag, and then you can use those lines just for more graphic ideas. Furthermore, you can do that with text as well. If we go to text, and then we go to text options, again, text fill and outline. If we go to solid line, let's choose a red color. And again, let's choose 5 and press enter. Again, text also has the ability to have an outline around it. And again, if you don't want a fill color, you can just use the outline for your text as well. The second thing I'm going to show you is gradients. Now these are really versatile. Now if we go back to our circle and we go down to gradient fill, and let's just get rid of the outer line, you can see we've got all these different options here. And most importantly, we've got this slider here with all of these markers on. So you can add or reduce the amount of markers you have, and this controls the color that you have in your gradient. So the first thing I'm going to do is just get rid of two of those by clicking on one of the markers and going to the remove gradient stop. So we've just got two markers now. If I slide this to the right, you can see I've got more white in my circle. And if I slide the blue one, I've got more blue in my circle. To change the colors, select the marker, go to color, select a color of your choice. Again, with the other one, let's select something quite dramatic. The other option with this is you've got preset gradients here, so you can just click on a gradient if you want to and it will just select it for you. But you can also change the direction of your gradients. Let's go to radial gradient, and you've got various options here as well, and you can change the direction of that gradient, and that really affects where the light is. And you can continue on down selecting ones of your choice. Now the reason these are so effective is because it really can lift your graphic design game. So let's say we were to duplicate this, and we can reduce the size of this circle, we can put it in the center, we can rotate it. And you can see how it will add that 3D effect where you can create a lot more exciting designs. When you further add a shadow, so go back up to the menu and click on the effects icon, go to shadow, and then add a shadow. And then you can play around with these sliders here. You can see that how that shadow has an effect. And then we can increase, decrease the size of those shadows and the blur, the angle, etc., where the light comes from, and the distance with that shadow. So using the gradients and the shadows can really elevate your designs. You can use exactly the same on borders as well. So if we select the text and we go to text outline, you can see we've got the option here of gradient line. So if we select that, again, let's just get rid of a couple of these markers. You can add more markers by using the plus sign here. Let's change the color. And again, you can use that for your text. You can use that for the inside fill color and or the external border color. And it just gives you another option to elevate your designs. The next thing I'm going to show you is the 3D effect. So if we select the shape, we go to effects and we go down to 3D format. We've got this option here called top bevel. If I click on the drop down here, we've got a number of bevel options. Again, elevating your design to more of a 3D effect. So I'm going to select this first one here. I'm going to use the increase arrow here. And as I do so, you can see the effect that that's having on the edge of my circle. If I then go to height and do the same here, you can see it has a slight effect on the edge here, and this is beginning to look now more like a disc. If I just go back quickly and change the colors on this disc to some lighter grays, you can now see that effect a little bit better. In addition to that, combined with rotation, so it's this drop down here, go to the presets and you can see we've got a number of options to rotate this disc on a number of different angles. Again, another effect to elevate your graphic design. The next thing I'm going to show you is about how you can layer your graphics. So for example, the text at the moment, as you can see, is disappearing behind this disc. And a lot of the time you may want this text on top of this disc. So all you need to do is select the item, go up to shape format and go along to bring forwards, click on the drop down and select bring forwards. And now your text is on top of that disc. In the same way that if we were to duplicate this disc, let's just quickly change the color. Let's just say we were to duplicate this a number of times and we wanted the gray one to come to the front. If you select it and instead of clicking on bring forwards, you go down and select bring to front, it will bring that one to the front. In the same way, if you just keep clicking on send backwards, it will send it back once and send it back twice. So if you've got lots of different text and you want it to appear just between two items you've selected, if you bring it forwards or backwards, it won't be the desired effect. So you can keep clicking on bring forwards or send backwards for it to be placed exactly where you want it. So the fifth, and for me, one of the most exciting things is the adaptation of shapes. So let's go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down, and let's just click and draw out a square. There we go. And I'm just going to take off the borderline, no line. And I'm also going to change the fill color to white. Okay, so we've got a plain rectangle, which has currently cut our circle in half. But what's really cool about these shapes is you can select them, go to Shape Format, go to Edit Shape, click on the drop down and select Edit Points. Now, these black markers can be moved in any direction, but it also has these handles where when you twist these handles or move the handles, they will create curves. So therefore, you can create additional shapes. You can also add those markers. If you can see, I've just hovered over that red line and click and drag. You can also add a marker as well. And this will effectively change your entire shape, giving you the flexibility to create exactly what you want. So once you've created the shape you want, if I just press enter, you can see we've selected this shape. We can now move this shape around. But you can also see that you've had an interesting effect on this circle itself. You can make it look as if it has been cut in a certain way. You can reduce the size of this design, move it around, you can angle it. And when you deselect it, you can have another desired effect on this circle. However, this is only going to work if you have a white background. If I change the background of this page to grey, now you can see why it will only work on a white background, because this white shape will always show. You can have a similar effect on text, so if you just wanted to cut through a certain point of text so that you had an interesting effect. Let's just put it over the T, and you can see it's just sliced through the T. And again, if you only wanted it to go through certain text, then again, you can create all kinds of effects. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.